art folks, it's Shade, and today I have something really special for you. Well, I always try to have something special for you, but this is extra special. Today I'm going to talk to you about Lebenzon handmade sustainable paintbrushes. I love supporting small businesses. I've talked to you before about handmade paint, but this time we're going to talk about handmade brushes. And it's not just that they're handmade brushes, but they're really beautiful and special handmade brushes. I'm going to talk about each of the different types of brushes that Tracy Lebenzon sent to me to try out, and I'll have timestamps in the description below. So definitely check them out there if there's a specific brush that you're interested in. And I'll also have my code, which is Shade, which would get you 20% off for the rest of the month, which I think is a really great discount for some really lovely brushes. So I'm gonna go through each of these by material. So first of all, we have these goat and synthetic brushes. Before I continue, I wanna talk about why these brushes are sustainable. So you know that I often work with Kolinsky sable brushes. And the problem with that is that many of the brushes do not have any information about the ethics of how the fibers are sourced. But natural hair brushes, in many cases, still have properties that, at least personally, I haven't seen in purely synthetic brushes. What I thought is so amazing about Tracy's brushes is that he either gets the hairs in ways that do not harm the animal, or he repurposes hairs that are found in various ways that were already in use. So no animal is actually being freshly harmed for these brushes. So if you ever wanted to try out natural hair brushes, but you were worried about an animal having to die for the sake of your brushes, this could be a great alternative. And also, since the handles are made out of bamboo, which is a quickly growing grass, you don't have the issue of trees being chopped down for your handles. Besides that, they just look cool. So when I talk about sustainability, that's what I'm talking about. And I think that the part of Tracy Lebenzon's purpose is really amazing. The first category I have is goat and synthetic. These are what you would call extender style brushes. The great thing about this type of brush is that it's a combination of natural hair and synthetic. So the natural hair, the goat in this case, acts to be able to absorb a lot of water. Goat hair really sucks up water. And then the synthetic gives you snap because goat hair is really floopy, and it also gives you a really sharp point. So you put those two together so that you can have the best of both worlds. Every single one of Tracy Lebenzon's brushes is totally unique. He works on every single one by hand, and every single one requires as many as 50 different steps to be made. And I was honestly not sure how they would be for my hands, since they don't have the traditional paintbrush shape. But so far, they've actually been really easy to use, partially because the hollow bamboo is so light. And I also find myself holding the brushes more loosely so that my hand doesn't cramp up in one position as much. I'm really surprised about that. Tracy doesn't send his brushes with any gum arabic on them, so they're pretty floofy when they arrive. But then when you put them in water, you can see how really sharp the tip is. And each of those heads are hand formed. So you can really see the great thing about these goat and synthetic mixed brushes, because you can go from having this super duper thin line to having this really thick line, which is something that you would have a lot of trouble getting with only synthetic or only natural hair alone. And it holds a lot of water and a lot of pigment. So you can see you can get these big, bold strokes, but also delicate strokes like grass or ribbon or calligraphy. What I'm using here is something called magic paper. This is something that you can also buy from Tracy Lebenzon's shop. And it's actually a really good tool for practicing calligraphy or practicing your brush strokes or testing out your brushes. This is not actually ink, this is just water. So when you paint with water on the paper, it turns black. And then when the paper dries, it goes white again. So here you can really just see how much water is held in a little brush like this. And this is just another size of the same type of brush. This is definitely one of my favorite brushes, and I think that it is so much fun to play with. And just to have the freedom to go from thick to extremely thin is amazing. I also just showed that if you press down on the belly of the brush on the side, it still has a ton of water because it has that goat hair there. And then you can get some really interesting dry brush shapes. Now, I only have one of these brushes. This is the Silver Fox brush, but to be honest, this is my absolute favorite. I wish I had more of these to try out because I think that they're gorgeous, but I'd like to try them in more sizes. The Silver Fox brush is made from the guard hair of certain silver foxes, and it's extremely rare type of hair. And apparently each strand is about 1/4 the diameter of a human hair. I would say that of the ones that I've tried, this is the closest to Kolinsky sable, and I think that's why I enjoy working with it so much. The design has these little notches on the end, so you wouldn't think about it from seeing it poofed out, but once it's wet, it really has this super fine tip and it's really springy. And the strokes that it make just feel like so organic and calligraphic. It's really nice. You can especially see it here with the magic paper. And the release of water is fairly consistent. I kind of love it. Next is goat. So this is the material that you might be thinking of if you're thinking of like a traditional Chinese or Japanese brush that you might have seen in the store. A lot of them have a goat base, or they have a mixture of different types of animal and synthetic hairs, including goat, because it just holds water so well. The bit of the problem with goat is that it doesn't release water and pigment as well as squirrel, but you can get goat hair without killing the animal, so. And this brush is a big mamma jamma. I was so surprised when I opened this one. I was like, what am I gonna do with this gigantor's brush? But it is actually so much fun. And it's really light because, like I said, the bamboo hollow handles are not heavy, and it's actually just interesting just to hold such a big handle. And you just get this just huge swatch of pigment. You can do sort of like petal strokes, and it goes surprisingly well from thin to thick, but it doesn't hold its form so much well, and that's just a characteristic of goat brushes in general. But you can use that aspect to your advantage and get different textures. I honestly just love watching this goat brush on the magic paper because it just looks so satisfying and luscious to see that really big, dark path of water. You can see in the beginning even, it's like completely drenched with water. So this is a really good brush to use like as a mop or to completely wet your paper before you start painting, or if you just really want to disperse a lot of paint and water somewhere. It goes down the whole page and I can just keep going. It's amazing. I feel like this would be a great brush if you wanted to do something like practice painting ensos. This is exactly the brush that I would imagine. It also just feels nice to have a different kind of relationship to your brushes, because like you're changing the ways that your hands are moving, so they're not always in the same position. So you're holding them all in different ways because they have different sizes. It's really interesting. Now, after the goat is the white synthetic. This is the brush that I'd have to say was most perplexing to me about how to deal with it, because this fiber is really more what you consider just your really standard run-of-the-mill synthetic fiber. The thing that's different about this brush though is that it's just really long. So it gives us this floppy texture, which you wouldn't find in your most standard brushes, which can end up doing curious things when you're painting. I'm not the biggest fan of how it doesn't hold its shape very well. You can get a fine line if you turn it in certain different kinds of ways. And because of how long the bristles are, they do hold a fair amount of water. But again, because it's a synthetic, the water tends to just drop off of it. You can see that I have drops coming off on the page before I even get to painting. But if you like synthetics and you like that droppy nature, then that's definitely something that you can work with. Now, these are two different types of brushes. The first one is a brown synthetic brush. So this is also a type of synthetic, but it's not the same as the white synthetic. This one definitely holds a lot more water, and it's very sharp and springy. I'd have to say that it's definitely has more resistance than a Kalinsky Sable brush does, which for me is not always my preferred for painting, but is really great for things like lines. These next four brushes are absolutely amazing for lines. I love them for lines. So, and the other one is a Siberian Elk. This is the itty bitty Siberian Elk brush, which is, I've got to say, one of my favorite, like these itty bitty brushes. I'm going to use this all of the time now. So the itty bitty brush is so cute, so super tiny, and the synthetic brush is also really beautiful and with a really nice sharp tip. You can see that you can get like beautiful lines, you can press down and it comes right back to a good shape. And the itty bitty brush, I don't even know if you can really see in the video. It's so super duper tiny. If you ever wanted those super duper tiny lines, but because of the length of the brush, it still actually can hold paint so that you're not dipping back into your pan every 5 seconds. It can actually hold paint and water, so you're getting a consistent line. Oh, it's heaven. It's beautiful. It's amazing. On the magic paper here, I'm using first the synthetic brush. And then next we have the itty bitty brush, and you can see that it doesn't hold tons of water, but for the size that it is, it gets that nice consistent one line. And when you're doing anything like grasses or telephone lines or eyelashes or highlights, anything like that, that's just such an amazing thing to have. I love these brushes. Okay, so next, I have two more sizes of the Siberian Elk. in general, the Siberian elk is a little bit softer than high quality Kalinske sable, maybe comparable to some lower grade Kalinske sables. Not in the sense of that they're lower grade, but that in the terms of their snappiness is a little softer and squishier. They still definitely go really nicely from thick to thin and have really nice even calligraphic strokes, also with even pigment distribution. And you can see that same thing on the magic paper. Really nice even distribution, and the medium one holds definitely more water than the super tiny one. For comparison, in case you wanted to see with a more conventional brush how that would perform on the magic paper, here is a size 4 Kalinske sable from Da Vinci. And here is a Tintoretto mop that's a goat imitation synthetic, and it's the largest mop that I have. And actually, I really love this mop. Tintoretto brushes are also amazing. So I wanted to do some demos so that you can really see how these brushes work. And the first one I'm doing is a much more loose sort of style, especially to use some of these much bigger brushes. So I go in with that white synthetic, which is fun, definitely just to lay down some colors. I'm also using the larger of the goat synthetic mixes, and you see how you can get this really nice, bold, thick line, and then use the tip for these little drawings of the, which honestly was so fun to paint. It was just really nice to be able to do that. I loved doing it. And then this is another side of the goat synthetic mixture, and just drawing and putting in color there. And then I'm using the goat just to put any sort of shadow or background wash. And you see just how much water it puts down there on the page. The pigment is a bit dilute because, as I said before, goat doesn't like to let go of pigment as well. But it's still definitely really nice and gives you this really soft look. Then to put in a bit of line, almost as if I was using a pen, but you don't have to, you can use a brush. I'm using the itty bitty Siberian elk brush, and it definitely is so nice for calligraphic marks. It's just really fun to go back in there and basically just draw on the painting. since the white synthetic is so floppy, I thought it would be perfect for making splatters, and it really is. So here I'm doing more of my normal style of a pomegranate from a photo that I took some while ago. And at first, it took a little while for me to get used to the brushes and figure out what sizes I wanted to use and which ones to use where. And also because for the diameter, they hold more water than I'm used to. So I had to get used to that as well and make sure not to use too much water when I was painting. So there might be a bit of a learning curve depending on how detailed that you're painting and how sensitive you are to your specific method of working with your brushes. For most of the painting, I end up using the Siberian Elk because I was able to get into those really tiny corners and it held paint really well. It was really interesting because it's possible to do some of my normal techniques with these brushes, but because of their length, I had to modify them a bit. And that also made me just think about putting down paint in different ways. So I was feeling like I was approaching things in some ways and more creatively because I was trying to play and kind of do things not necessarily in the way that I always do. And that was really fun. I really enjoyed just like how sharp these tips are, especially on the smaller brushes. It's really amazing. I'm going to be using that all the time. A little more about the brushes. In case you were wondering just how handmade these brushes are, Tracy Lebenzon even collects the bamboo for these brushes himself. He actually put up Craigslist ads and offered to do maintenance on bamboo groves and people's homes. That's where these bamboo handles come from. So he's definitely putting in the work. As I said, the natural hair bristles either come from renewable sources that don't harm the animal, as where you can just cut their hair like goat or pony, or they come from things like estate sales, where he gets the hairs from coats or things like that and then uses them in the brush. So in none of these procedures are animals hurt. You can kind of think about it as a sort of thrifting or recycling or upcycling. He's also so certain that his brushes will last that he actually has a lifetime guarantee on the material and workmanship of all the brushes, which is really impressive. And also, I know that these are a ton of different types of brushes. So actually, when he contacted me, I was not sure what I wanted to use, but I told him what brushes I normally used, and based on that, he did research and he actually presented brushes to me. And if you are confused about what type of brush that you would like to use, definitely reach out to Tracy Lebenzon. He is so nice and so responsive and so knowledgeable. Now, one of my favorite parts here was doing something that I never thought that I would do. I added gouache to this painting and I used white gouache for highlights. Like, okay, I know everybody does this, but I don't do it because I normally really hate the way that it looks. It feels like, at least when I do it, I feel like it looks very fake and plastered on, but I used the itty bitty Siberian Elk brush for doing this, and I felt like I got the thinnest lines. It laid down so evenly. It had such nice coverage, and it just felt really natural, pretty highlights on top of my paint, and I was in love. I was so happy. This was like honestly my favorite part of the entire painting. I also used it to do the little furry, hairy bits at the top of the pomegranate, but putting in those highlights, and now I understand what people are talking about when they say that like putting in the highlights is the best part. I understand you now, I just needed the right brush. This is the brush, Itty Bitty Siberian Elk. So this is how the pomegranate turned out, and like I said, I love these brushes. If you're interested, definitely contact Tracy or even ask some questions here. He's really responsive and I'm sure that he'll try to get back to you. I'll have links to all of the brushes in the description below. And like I said, if you use my name, Sade, S-A-D-E as the code, you will get 20% off. And that's perfect, just in time for Christmas. Even the watercolor artist who has it all in your life probably doesn't have one of these brushes, and they are really beautiful and amazing to work with. I hope that you guys really enjoyed this video. I loved working with these brushes, and you'll definitely be seeing me work with them more. Thank you so much for watching. An extra special shout out to my patrons. This year has been a year, hasn't it? Well, let's definitely go out with a bang, okay guys? I hope that you're all safe and sound. And again, just thank you so much to my patrons. See you guys next time. And until then, be gentle with yourself. Bye.